What's up, everybody? Coach Trevor here. So today in this video, we're gonna go over the kettlebell full snatch. So in the previous video, we talked about hitting the half snatch where you pull it down to rack position. So this video is mostly focusing on the down phase of the snatch, which is actually probably the hardest part. So what needs to be talked about is the catching position. Like we've talked before, you're gonna catch it on the base of the corner of the palm and the meat of the thumb, okay, when you do your snatch. When you're done with it, from the top position, you're actually going to toss it out and try to go in reverse in which the same way it came up, right? So it went from a high pull to a punch up. So when you're tossing it out, you're actually gonna bypass the calluses and then hook it on your fingertips. And once you catch on your fingertips, you should have relatively good control over it in this high pull position, a reverse high pull, right? Because we're going down and then throw it back at your hips. Make sure the weight doesn't drop down, okay? Because that's a common error with the kettlebell snatch when we first learned this, okay? So I'll do a few reps just so you know what it looks like. So start with it in front, boom. So hike it back, elbow up, punch through. So from here, abs on tight, toss it out, hook it on the fingertips. Make sure when you're hitting these, elbow comes up, punch, that when you toss it out, you're not tossing it way out this way. I'm basically tossing it right in this general region. Boom, keeping it close, punching through all the way up, right? Oh, it's coming up, punch through. Nice and easy, okay? Another thing is on the backswing, make sure your wrist is the same spot of your thigh every time, okay? It's important that when we're tossing it out, like I mentioned before, the arc always has to stay the same. So when you're tossing it out, a lot of times people throw it too far and they start catching it too low and the weight will drag them down. So it's important that you just kind of barely, lightly toss it out, hook it on your fingertips here, so you're in this high pull position, and just slowly guide it back towards the hips as you hit your hinge, and then reset, right? Popping the hips, elbow comes up for the high pull, punching up in one motion. Another thing is too, is obviously the planking and the catch. To integrate that, I would probably say if they're having issues on the swing variation of it, add like a high pull, or you can even go back to where they're doing the hang cleans or the like a dead stock clean. Basically teaching them to keep the kettlebell close to their body, right? Even though it's a swinging motion and the kettlebell does come out, the idea behind it is to keep it close as we're doing the swing portion of it. And of course, it just takes lots of reps as well. Like sometimes you need a lighter weight, takes lots of reps, takes time. It's probably one of the hardest things to teach us is the kettlebell clean and the kettlebell snatch, right? But the cool thing is like once they master this, they actually turn into complete badasses. Their confidence goes way through the roof, and that's what we want as trainers.